y'all can get the fuck off IG and join the Twitch.
That's what I'm saying. Twitch, I'm like, bro. I thought it was fucking on you because you, like, you seen me press friggin' like start. Remember?
Yeah.
I didn't stop it or anything.
Yeah.
No, that's fucked. I'm like looking at a screen. I'm like, what the fuck's
OBS
going on?
OBS is tripping, fam.
Yeah, yeah.
OBS
all good.
Is tripping. Yeah,
it's
man.
All good though.
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah. Okay, so next. For music, entertainment, and other stuff. Tell me about the new Bel Air show.
The new Bel Air show?
Yeah, the new Fresh Prince of Bel Air.
So did you watch the trailer at least?
I think I've seen it once.
Seen it once?
Yeah.
So this is like more dark and twisted compared to the last one.
Yeah, the sitcom, the original sitcom.
Yes.
Yeah. This ain't a sitcom this time. It's like a drama series.
So yes. So with the Bel Air... Bro, like, Carlton is really fucked up in this one. I'm just going to get off this IG.
Yeah, exactly.
Because I don't know what the hell is going on over here.
Talking shit in the comments, distracting him, bro. Get on Twitch, y'all. Log
get
off.
On Twitch.
Get and on video. Twitch. Get off IG Live, y'all. But, yeah, I never thought it would actually... Because, like, when I saw the trailer, I'm like, you know what? I'm not interested in watching this shit.
Nah, like, the first episode, it's, like, a lot happening... In the first one,
okay.
So it's like everything, like, you know, the original where he's on the playground, like, friggin', like, obviously shooting bat, he's playing basketball, sorry.
Yes.
And then he gets into a fight or whatever. This one, the guy friggin' pulls out a gun and, like, shoots in the air.
Oh, okay.
Like, you actually see, like, everything.
Wow.
So they're going, like, more violent or whatever, right? So
yeah, for real.
So I'm like, what the fuck?
Oh, that's crazy.
So, like, but everything happened in one. I didn't, in the first episode, like, as soon as that happens, his mom brings him there, like, already.
Yes.
But I'm like, so the gangster guy who went to jail with Will.
Yes.
He's still trying to find Will.
Oh, okay.
Because, like, I think... They said he snitched or something. So then obviously the gang member is trying to go after him or something like that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, shit. Okay.
So then you have Carlton, which is not the same Carlton at all.
Yeah, not the same one. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
This one's fucking full on drugs, everything.
Crazy, yeah.
I don't know what the fuck happened to this guy. And the new one, man, he's really fucked up.
He went from doing the dance to doing drugs.
Like, he's doing, yeah, you're not, he ain't doing the Carlton in this.
Definitely
like,
not.
Like, if you're coming to watch the new Bel Air,
yeah,
there's no Carlton dance.
Yeah, based on what you're telling me after what you saw,
no.
It's definitely
the man's freaking snorting coke in his own closet, bro.
Oh,
in the mansion.
Shit.
It's fucked. Like the first episode, you'll probably think the same thing, like it's too much.
Yeah.
But as soon as you watch episode 2 and 3, then you're obviously going to be like, yo, like, I want to see more.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is Uncle Phil alive in this?
That's kind of stupid.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
a stupid question, sir.
Yeah. Rest in peace.
It's a different actor, so of course he's alive.
Yeah. I was just asking, everything could you use a stupid question. Oh, that's gay. That's a gay question. That's a stupid
question.
That's
like saying, is Will Smith
Because I
alive?
Didn't watch it, Sherlock.
But that's basically, yeah, but that's basically saying, yo, is Will Smith alive in the show?
Yeah, I was asking about Uncle Phil.
Yeah.
Idiot boy.
I'm telling you, that's like the same
question.
Yeah,
I was just asking you because you watched the show and I didn't.
Okay.
Oh, that's a stupid question. It's a stupid question. Man, took that personally.
Yes, and Viv is alive too, but thanks for asking.
Yeah.
Yes.
Who else is alive in it?
Everybody else.
Good. Because you watch the show, so I'm asking you.
You're asking me. Everybody on the set is alive.
They better be alive. And you better be right.
I better be right. This guy.
Yeah, so how much episodes you watch?
There's only 3 out, so I watched all 3.
All 3? Okay.
Well, like on Global, for some reason, you know, like the Peacock network, right?
Yes.
For Peacock. Some reason, they only put out 1.
Yeah.
And then when you go on streaming websites, there's all 3. There's all 3.
Yeah.
So, like, I don't understand, like...
Yeah.
Like, what's going on?
Oh, yeah, true. Okay. So, how much episodes in total for, like... Is it going season by season? Is the first season, right?
The what?
Yeah, like...
Oh, I don't know, like, how much number of, like, seasons are going...
Yeah.
For, like, how many episodes. I think Google tells you.
Yeah.
After you go live, you fucking discard. I don't
know.
Oh,
yeah, yeah. Just saving that shit.
Forget.
They'll let that stay in the archives.
Yeah, it stays in there for 30 days anyways, it says anyways.
Yeah, oh yeah, when you just delete it. Yeah. Okay, okay.
Let me check on Google right now. Bel Air.
Yeah, like how much episodes per
season
for the new
one? Yeah, it usually tells you.
Yeah.
me see. Episode list.
And, like, how long is each episode? Like, half an hour or 1 hour?
It's, like, almost 50 minutes.
Okay, okay. Almost an hour. Okay. Considering that there's no commercial and breaking and shit like that. And
I don't know why it's going back.
Yeah, to come on. Google's supposed to be our best friend, yet it's slacking right now. Is it there?
Showing episode 10. But I don't see nothing else after episode
so 10. So it's a 10 episode season. Or it
could
season.
Be more. I don't know.
Yeah, like for the... Because
on Google right now, it's only showing 10 episodes.
Okay.
So I don't... It's not showing any other...
Yeah.
Like, it, you go to episode 10, that's all it's showing.
Yeah. Okay. So it's 3 episodes that come out each week?
I'm assuming so, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Which gives, like, you know, the viewer or, like, more to watch.
Because if you go on the global app, like the global, like, CBC or whatever app,
yeah,
it's only showing you one episode on there.
Yeah.
Because I watched it, and then someone's like, no, there's 3 episodes out.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, what the fuck are you talking about, 3 episodes out? So the next morning, I go online, I'm like, yo, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, I was looking for this for, like, so long.
Yeah, they didn't even tell you at first. All of a sudden, it's 3 episodes at you at once in the first week. And it's, like, 50 minutes each long, yeah. So, okay, I might check it out still. Because, like, at first, I wasn't interested. I'm like, yo, there shouldn't be a new Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. But considering, like, what you told me, I'm like, okay, they're not trying to, like, mimic or do a, like, a, do a spin-off or reboot or whatever, try copy this shit. It's, like... a totally different turn, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
No, like, they just took... They basically, I don't know, like, they pulled more of the unseen drama out of the original Fresh Prince.
Yeah, there's, like, it's not really... The new like, one. There is, like, some funny moments.
Yeah.
But it's not, like...
Well, not unseen drama. Just made it a different thing, you know? Made turning it into a genre, like, but just for, like, the new generation. So, yeah, yo. Like, instead of things being funny and happy... You know, everything's just, you know, darker and grim and serious. So, yeah, man. I would imagine for them to, like, take this kind of approach to making a new Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. But, you know, I wouldn't mind checking it out. I won't be quick to check it out, but, you know,
yeah, yeah.
I'll just continue to hear your take on it.
No, watch it.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know about watching it still.
Bro, like, the first episode, you'll probably be like, nah, I'm not going to watch it. But as soon as you get to, like, episode 2,
yeah.
You're going to keep saying, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, no, watch it.
Oh, okay. I'll watch it eventually. Yeah. Eventually.
You're not going to watch it.
Yeah. Well, so now that you told me Coco Jones is in it, I'll consider watching it with her fine ass.
You better watch it.
What's it called? What do you mean? Man's making a demand. You better watch it. Yeah, I better not watch it. Yeah, I'll give it a soon, but yeah, I won't be quick to watch it anyways. But well, okay, what else is
popping? Oh, the Kanye West thing you wanted to do.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's dropping Donda 2 next week, but it's not going to be on streaming.
It's called the Steam player. It's called the Steam player.
Not Steam, STEM.
STEM?
Yeah, STEM player. He called it Steam.
Steam, STEM. It basically almost looks like something like this, but smaller.
Yeah.
Like it's a fucking speaker.
Yeah.
So what? That holds your music onto it.
I guess so, yeah.
Well, you just, like, download your music to it?
I really don't know. He's doing that for people to listen to Donda 2 instead of dropping it on any platforms, any music platforms, you know? So, yeah. Like, and it's $200.
Yeah, $200.
Yeah.
But when you can just... I'm pretty sure the album's going to leak anyways.
Exactly, bro. You know? Like, I stay, you know, finding ways to listen to shit and download shit for free, you know? So, yeah, because, like, as a DJ, I got to supply the tunes. I can't be keep paying for music. I have 8,000 songs downloaded. That's fucking $8,000 that I would have to spend, you know? Like, these days, fuck that shit. I'm not trying to pay for music because I have to pay a few hundred dollars for the license to play the music through the software. So, any illegal free download plug, I'm going to it.
Exactly. I'm pretty sure that's going
to
happen.
Yeah. MP3 Skull, MP3 VIP, YouTube to MP3, anything, bro. But yeah, like, to be honest, like, I understand what where Kanye is coming from. Like, what did he say? Like, he said something about, Today's artists get just 12% of the money the industry makes. It's time to free music from this oppressive system.
So, yeah. So why doesn't he just do what Tory Lanez did?
Yeah.
Why didn't he just make the NFT album of Donda 2?
Yeah.
And sell it for a dollar?
Yeah.
And then you'll be making like millions.
Yeah, Kanye is the type to do, to try, always try to do things differently.
No, yeah, but he's selling his thing for $200.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure, what, is he in the millions right now already?
Like
pre-orders, I'm assuming, if there's pre-orders already out.
Yeah. Well, I'm not sure if the pre-orders are, yeah. But if he's going to make some money off of it, then sure, more power to him, you know. But
yeah, yeah.
I disagree with, you know, with having to charge people $200 for this new speaker you're selling just to listen to
Donda 2. No, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Like, he should at least, like,
yeah,
do the NFT thing. Call it Donda 2.
Yeah.
But at least sell it for, like, maybe $5-$10.
Yeah, exactly,
and then
bro.
Someone's going to resell it. You could do that.
Yeah. And plus,
like,
yeah,
you'd be making more money doing that.
Yeah, and plus, I'm not against spending $200 on a speaker, but to buy a speaker for $200 just to listen to an album.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah,
it's
yeah.
like I'm basically just paying $200 for new music.
Yep.
Like, who spends that much on music anyways? You know, so yeah, yo. Like, I just heard that today. I'm like, you know what? Yeah.
Yeah, because I seen one of I don't know what page it was. They were posting it.
Yeah.
I'm like, that just seems kind of stupid.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I understand the Spotify thing. Like, yeah, you're not making, like, any money from the streaming services.
Yeah.
But at least try to find another way so you can make.
Exactly. Yeah. You know, so people can listen to it while you make more, you know. So, yeah. You know. But then again, I'm not in the industry. I don't know the industry. But, yeah, like, I don't necessarily agree, you know, with this way of distributing the music.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and what else did he say? It's like, oh, it's time to take control and build our own. Go to stemplayer.com now to order.
And then I also was reading comments too. I'm like, why am I going to pay $200?
Yeah.
Just to listen to Pete Davidson diss tracks.
Exactly, bro. We're just going
It's true, though.
Yeah. Or I can just keep bumping Donda 1. Easy.
Yeah, you can do that too. Hey, yo.
That came out during the summer, not too long ago.
The original Donda is on this, on here. I'm selling it for $300, okay?
Yeah.
$300. American.
Yeah.
So when it comes to Canadian, it's more money. I need that money.
Yeah, that's like
OCP needs that money. And also,
yeah,
you also get a bonus mixtape from OCP on here too.
Yeah, that's
Pod
on
now, stream later. Okay? It's on there.
That's almost like with podcasters, like, yo, any podcast we upload, you have to you can't listen to it on Apple. Or anywhere you get podcasts.
No.
Only for the speaker that you're going to have to buy for $200, $300.
You can't listen to our podcast. You know why? Because you don't have headphones. So you're going to have to buy our headphones. You can only buy our headphones to listen to our podcast.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. But I'm pretty sure, like,
this is the OCP Dr. Dre version, by the way.
But you're playing. Yeah. What's it called? I feel like he may drop it on streaming services later on. Maybe this could be an experiment at first.
Yeah.
Just to see how much people would buy it.
Yeah. But I'm pretty sure if people like diehard fans, obviously it's going to get sold out. But like, here you go, guys.
Yeah.
$300 Donda 2 right here. I got it. I got it before Kanye got it. It's all mixed and mastered already. It's all right here. It's all right here, man. Just press play.
Yeah.
Just press play, guys.
If people can go in line for Yeezys without that cost bare money, I'm pretty sure they'll be willing to do this, you know?
And speaking of, oh, you mean his shoes, right?
Yeah, the shoes, yeah.
I just ordered Jordan, I think it was Jordan 5s.
Okay.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air edition.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So just waiting for that to come in.
Oh, you already ordered it?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, like, what's the pair saying? $200? No, I'm playing. A little lower than that, right?
Sure, we could say that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I still need to buy new shoes, but I'm cheap as fuck. I don't even buy Jordans. I just go to the shoe company, try to get a discount. Yeah, man. So, okay.
It's like an early birthday present to myself.
Of course, you got to treat yourself, you know?
Yes.
Yeah, man.
And then I bought the statement jersey.
Yeah.
So I'm waiting for that one to come in.
Okay.
The black and red one for the Raptors?
Yes, yeah, yeah.
So, you know that number 4-4?
Black and red or not? Yeah, not the black and gold. Black and red, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I keep forgetting.
I'm not really feeling the black and gold.
Yeah.
Like, maybe the shorts are okay, but the jersey, not really. But, like, the statement jersey where it has, like, the Jordan symbol on it?
Yes, yeah.
The red and black.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, okay, okay.
So just, it said that's not going to be ready until March.
Till March, okay.
Yeah.
A bit of a shipping delay.
Yes.
Yeah, it happens.
And then I also, you know how I told you the Kobe documentary will be coming out in, what was it, June, I think?
Did we say August, June? August.
August, sorry.
Yes, or is
August.
It pushed back?
No, no, it's this year.
Yeah, this year.
But for some reason in my head, I thought it was June for some reason.
Oh, yeah. But August, yeah.
So, yeah. So I bought another rookie card off of eBay.
Okay.
So waiting for that to come in.
Yeah.
And I was thinking of also making like a side page of just like all the basketball cards that I have as well.
Okay.
So like that would be pretty sick. Like out of control cards or something.
Yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like every basketball like card I have, I'll put it like, I'm not going to sell them.
Yeah.
Like if someone wants to pay top dollar, sure. But I'm not going to sell like the Kobe ones.
Yeah. Of course not.
So yeah, it'd be pretty cool to like see what I have and like just post it online as well too.
Okay.
So yeah, that's what I was thinking of. Like doing like another like side page.
Side page, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because then I'll have three Kobe rookies, two Shaq rookies.
Yes.
And then whatever's in the binder.
Yeah.
Yep.
August, it's coming, bro.
It's coming.
Yeah, like buy them shits off of Matt, bro. When them shits cost $1 million a card.
No, because I know his rookies will go up even more.
Yeah, when the documentary.
Yeah, because I know Jordan stuff like went up a lot.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, definitely, bro. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, just like what's it called? I know with the crypto.com coins, that shit will go up later on in value. So the best time to do it is to invest now.
Like right now, yeah.
Yeah, like exactly. while the Lakers are shit and make the play in. You know, this is the best time to buy some crypto.com coin.
That LeBron James commercial that he did.
Yeah.
Didn't see it?
Oh, which commercial was it?
That he did. It was from crypto.com.
Oh, I didn't see that, no.
No, you didn't see it?
No.
Wow.
Yeah, I haven't seen it. It's on YouTube, right?
Yeah,
it's on YouTube. I didn't know he did one with crypto.com.
He did it for like the halftime. Because for us, some commercials did show down here, the American ones.
Yes,
but
yeah.
But mostly the American ones showed in only on the like American station where they're showing the football game. They were showing the football game in Canada.
Yes.
But there wasn't that many American commercials.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So it was like a commercial like by himself.
Yeah.
Like talking to his younger self.
Oh.
Like a
I know what you're talking about now. Yeah.
Yeah, like he posted it on his Instagram.
Okay.
So like he's basically like himself telling him like, yo, how do I get to the league? LeBron's like, yo, man, you got to take your own shots. Mm. And then at the end, they're like, I'm going to the league. Basically, like he's making to the NBA.
Yeah.
So basically, like a younger version of himself talking to his older self.
Yeah, I see. It's like, the younger self is like animated, 3D animated.
Yeah. Like it looks exactly like him.
Like him, yeah.
Unless they just did you know, like the face over.
Yes.
It could have been like someone else's body.
CGI effect or some shit. Yeah.
Because like the face looks exactly like how he was in high school. Great. Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah. So far, I only saw like a still photo with the meme saying like, yo, if Russell Westbrook calls, don't answer. Saw that on Twitter.
I didn't even see that one.
Yeah. And I'm like, yo, where's this from? And I'm like, oh, now that you told me, I'm like, yeah, it's from a LeBron commercial. So yeah, I'm going to check it out still, bro. Okay, what else is in music, entertainment, and other shit? Okay, not play.
Okay.
Yeah. The Anthony Hamilton Music Soul Child Versus. That was a cool, fun versus.
That was last week, no?
Oh, no, this week. Yeah, it was on Tuesday, the day after Valentine's Day.
Well, I'm surprised they didn't do it on Valentine's
Day. Yeah. I'm like, yo, you guys should have done this on the weekend. Stop doing verses on a weekday.
Yeah,
like,
that's what I don't understand.
Especially when y'all start on nigga time. Not starting on time. But yeah, it was a cool, fun versus. I picked the wrong winner. Anthony Hamilton.
Oh, your boy came out with a new song.
Who? Jack Harlow? Nail Tech. Oh, yeah, he came out with a new song.
Yo, the video goes hard. Not going to lie still.
Yeah, I know. I saw the thumbnail. I'm going to check it out still. Man drops it the same day he's playing in the Y'all's celebrity game.
Yeah, how exactly. Yep. And then I also heard on Donda 2.
Yeah.
Kid Cudi is not on it. Because he said Kid Cudi is friends with Pete Davidson. So Kanye's like, you're not on the album. He goes, you won't be seeing Kid Cudi on the album because he's friends with that guy.
...
Exactly. He's like, you know, the photos that he's been posting with like the notepad and he's been writing shit on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like he wrote it on there. He's like, Kid Cudi won't be on the album due to this. I'm like, okay.
Yeah. This is just, I know.
And y'all being petty, bro.
Yeah.
Like, who cares? Yeah, Pete Davidson fucked Kim Kardashian. Who cares, bro?
Like, gosh, man.
Even if they didn't, who cares?
Don't you got a quote-unquote new bitch that's bad already?
There was also a post that she's saying they broke it off, so I don't know.
Oh, him and Julia Fox, that girl that we had no idea.
Yeah, something about they broke it off. I don't know if it's true or not, but I was seeing posts that they broke it off.
Yeah.
So I don't know.
Yeah, but the funny thing is, on Kanye's YouTube, I mean, man, I'm getting tired, my bad. Instagram, like, there's a video of him, like, you know, like what's it called? Like, just, like just in, like, him talking in the background, explaining his flaws and shit, talking about,
talking about, like, the car ride video that he did, no?
Yeah, yeah, like, you know, like, one of the reasons why his marriage didn't work with Kim was, like, you know, his mental health issues and him spending too much money. But now...
But what has he been spending money on?
I really don't know. Line? I guess so, yeah. But like,
there's nothing else.
Yeah, but I really don't know. But then again, he's a billionaire. He can spend money like crazy.
No, that's what I'm saying. So that shouldn't care.
Yeah.
That shouldn't like matter about anything.
Yeah, exactly. You know, but yeah. But still, like, I guess this is just... He's just doing these antics just to, you know, for marketing to big up his new album anyways. Because like, yo, this is like, you know... Like, in order to, like, you know, get some buzz and get people talking about you, you have to do some antic shit, you know? And, of course, people are going to talk about it. And I know Kanye's being petty, but intentionally petty because his pettiness is going to help him get more clicks and more interest for the new album, you know? So, and yeah, I know, Black History Month, you got to go all out and shit, but not like this, man. You can't be going at, you know, like... Yeah, you can't be going at you like that. No, I'm not even trying to finish that sentence. I'm not even trying to finish that. But I'm saying,
I ain't trying to finish that.
It's like, yo, dog, to be honest, bro, like, I don't even like talking about celebrity couples and breakups and shit like that. It's like, and I think, what's it called? Wasn't he hosting Saturday Night Live last week, or is he hosting it this week?
Who?
Kanye.
No, I don't know, to be honest. I didn't hear about if he was hosting it.
Yeah, I heard something about it. I'm not sure if it's true or not.
But if he's... Like, I know he put it in his verse that when he rolls up to SNL, he's going to send, like, 100 people after Pete.
Yeah.
But I'm pretty sure if Kanye goes to SNL, I don't think Pete will even be there.
Yeah, I doubt it.
Or unless this is just for, like a publicity stunt, to make them, like do skits about it.
It
got to
be a publicity stunt, man. You know,
something, but
it's like, yo, these guys are in Hollywood, you know? And plus, what does Kim even see in Pete Davidson? You know, like that.
What does anybody see in that guy?
That's such a celebrity mismatch. You know, like, dog, if it wasn't for the fame and money, he wouldn't be getting no pussy right now. Like,
exactly.
The fuck?
Facts.
Yeah, he'd just be on, like me, seeking, going on Leo list.
Facts.
I'm playing. Okay.
On Leo list.
Yeah. What else was I going to say? Okay. What else? Okay. Yeah. Like Canadian news, the vaccine mandates are announced to be lifted
on March 1st. No,
for Ontario, yes.
Yes.
Right now it's the 18th as we're recording.
Are they gonna February, you know, when you 18th. Go for traveling, right?
Yeah.
Do you think they'll change it? Because I know people who only have two doses.
Two doses. Yeah.
So do you think they'll change it to, like, when you go to travel, you need 3 doses?
Yeah. For now, yeah.
For now, but yeah. Like, do you think they'll change it to that? Or they'll keep it at, like, 2.
Whether 2 or 3 shots, whether you can still travel without
having
to get
tested. Yeah,
because
right now, if I go into a restaurant, I only have 2 shots, right?
Yeah.
I'm still allowed in.
Yeah.
But I don't know, coming March 1st, are they going to change it to, like, if you go on vacation, when they scan it.
Yeah.
Because I know... So when you go traveling, they said you don't need to do the rapid test when you come back to Canada, right?
Yeah, if you're vaccinated.
If you're vaccinated.
Yeah.
But what is their what does it mean, though?
I think that's for fully vaccinated. Fully, people.
Like, 3 and 4 doses or just 2 doses?
I guess it's for the 3 doses.
So that means if I go, I still need to do a rapid test with just 2 vaccines. That's kind
of
stupid.
Yeah, that's stupid, you know? So it's like, bro, what's the point of traveling right now?
Yeah.
Just because, you know, mans didn't take the vaccine or didn't take all 3 shots, you know? So, yeah. I mean, I'm cool with waiting. Like I said, I'm not trying to take... I'm not taking no trips at all this year. Whatever vacation I plan to take next, that can wait till next year, at least in the spring or summer next year. So, yeah, I mean, at least I can walk inside a public building, eat inside a restaurant, you know, as an unvaccinated person without having to show proof.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, so I'm happy about that.
That, but then it's about the freaking, and then the mask. I just want that shit.
Yeah, yeah, we still have to wear a mask, you know, so yeah, yo. Like, again, everything's so conflicting and contradicting. Why people who get vaccinated still have to wear a mask? And we've been in lockdown like two more times when people took the vaccine, so, you know, and they conveniently and start lifting these mandates, you know, when the protests start happening, you know, talking about, oh, we're doing this because it's safe to do so. We're in
they're just doing that because of the protests.
Exactly. They're getting on your ass right exactly. now. You guys feel the pressure.
And everybody's laughing at Trudeau right now. Anyway,
exactly. So. Like, dog, Trudeau's not it, bro. Like, yo, there's...
Definitely not it.
Like, dog, there's an old video. I don't know from how many years
ago. Yeah, the Ford video, right?
Doug Ford talking about, oh, Justin Trudeau's not equipped to run this country. Of course. But, of course, yo, this is why I don't vote. Y'all vote the same dumbass people in every few years back in the office, you know? Like, yo... Back in at work today during lunch break.
Let me guess, we were talking about CP24.
We were talking about how Jean Chrétien was a G, bro. Like, yo, for you millennials, yo, Jean Chrétien, when he was the prime minister, bro, he was a G. He was my favorite celeb. He was my favorite at the time. His
favorite celebrity.
Yeah, I mean, not well, okay, yeah, I can put it.
But you were about to say celebrity.
Yeah, because, you know, because I was like, I was a kid. So yeah, I'm like, who's the prime minister? Jean Chrétien. Okay, Jean Chrétien. Never heard anything bad about him. But of course, this was in a pre-social media world. No phones and shit. But then again, of course, it's clear that today, these days, like how much of an idiot Justin Trudeau is. Like, get him the fuck out of here, you know? And of course, with the bullshit propaganda talking about, this anti-vaccine protest, what's it called? It's unlawful. It's criminal-like and whatever. But yeah, you have fucking policemen on horses trampling peaceful protesters to death, where one fucking elderly protester fucking died from being trampled by one of the horses. So, you know, it's all on you, Trudeau. Like, who's really unlawful here? You know, they just want freedom from these unnecessary vaccine mandates that shouldn't be in place place at all. You know, like, just give people a choice. Let people take the vaccine if they want to. You know, if you take it, good for you. It's okay. But not everyone has to take it.
No, like, exactly. Yeah. It's basically a choice.
Because it's not stopping the virus. It's science, not really working.
Science.
Exactly. Science. No, I'm
science
not.
My says body, this. Yeah. Science says that.
Exactly, bro. Like, dog, I'm not putting anything in my body that, you know, that the government says we should put in just because they say this is the only way out the pandemic. When the pandemic is never going to go away.
It was never a freaking pandemic. Yeah, it was a plandemic.
Yeah, plandemic. That's all I was going to say, bro. You know? So, yeah. And plus, like, there's other parts of the world that have no vaccine mandates. So, why Canada? You know? Like, why Canada right now? But then again, I know, like you said, for the vacation vaccine mandates, as all provinces start going in this direction...
Like, you could still go.
Yeah, but I have to I have to isolate for 2 weeks. There's no fucking point then.
It's not 2 weeks anymore.
It's 2 weeks?
No, it's less than 2 weeks, I think.
Well, that's what I heard them say.
They're trying to say, like, it's 5 days now. Or it's
5 days, yeah.
So 5 days is a week.
But still, I'd rather not go on vacation at all. Because if I have to stay in...
Because other than that, it's like $50-$60 to do, like, a rapid test type thing.
Yeah, exactly. No, it's just an incentive just for make everyone get vaccinated.
No, not even that. It's just them making more money.
Exactly. It's money for the pharmaceutical companies. It's like, bro, how you sheep not know that, bro? Like, if you guys lived long enough to experience SARS, there was no vaccine back then. And I was more scared about COVID now.
Yeah, but when they said, like, when we had SARS back then, there was what? Not even, like, 5% people were wearing masks.
Exactly.
In the airport, sure, but it wasn't, like, 80%. Like, no one was scared of it back there.
And that was more so like in Asia.
That's what I'm saying.
So yeah.
But when it came here, nobody was doing shit.
Exactly, bro.
It's a fucking plandemic, bro.
Yeah, it is a plandemic.
Bullshit needle.
You know? Exactly. Fuck that shit, you know?
Like, fucking two's enough, bro. Even one's enough.
Yeah, like dog.
Like, you don't need to take more than two, bro. I'm telling you.
Exactly, man. Like, fuck that shit, bro. Like, people shouldn't have to take something like that just to keep their job. or just to travel without isolating.
But think about this. If they're taking the QR code, like the vaccine mandate, if they're taking it away.
Yes.
So what's going on with the people that got fired from their jobs?
They should get their jobs back, yo.
They should.
I was, yeah.
Yeah, they should be fighting for that shit.
Yeah, me and my... Exactly. Yeah, me and my, what's it called? My assistant supervisor at work, we were talking about that. People who lost their jobs from not taking the vaccine should get their job back.
They should, 100%.
You know, because this shit was forced in the first place, you know?
I think...
Yeah.
Yeah, because... So basically, they lost their job for basically 2 years.
Yeah.
And then they're like, no, you need to be vaccinated.
Yeah.
And now coming March 1st, you don't even show proof that you need to be vaccinated or not.
Exactly.
Like, it's fucking retarded.
About you're putting other people at risk by not taking the vaccine. Bullshit. They can still get it. They still have to wear a mask.
Last week on national TV, on CP24.
Exactly.
He said, even if you have your 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th shot, you could still catch COVID. Exactly. So why are we still living like this?
Exactly. So what's the fucking point?
Exactly.
The flu's been around for a minute, yet you weren't telling people to get vaccinated back then.
Yeah.
So why now?
So during the flu, freaking work didn't pay me 2 weeks to be off work.
Yeah.
So basically when I have the flu now, you're going to pay me to be off? Okay. No problem.
Exactly,
bro. No problem. I'll take fucking days off for free.
Yeah, and when people caught the flu, like you, it wasn't like, oh, 2 weeks self-isolation.
That's what I'm saying.
Five days self-isolation on vacation. Exactly. Rapid test. Like, nah, yo.
Especially when we came back from vacation that year, too.
Yeah, Luciferians, bro, telling you.
I'm like, as soon as we came back, they're like,
yeah.
Oh, no, you got to stay home for 2 weeks.
Exactly.
My first question was, am I getting paid?
Yeah.
And, plus, and they're like, yeah, you're getting paid.
Yeah, and like, yo, why does fucking Bill Gates, of all people, have a say in what people should do with the pandemic? That guy ain't no fucking doctor.
It's not that.
That guy's the CEO of Windows, a fucking computer company. He probably
wants everybody to be, like, chipped or some shit like that.
Exactly, but like, fuck out of here, man.
Fuck that shit.
Yeah, and is he even taking the vaccine himself? I bet. No, I bet he took saline.
I don't know. I think most of the celebrities, they did get vaccinated.
Yeah.
And, like, most of them... that didn't they don't talk about it as much, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Shout out to the celebs that didn't get vaccinated.
Yep.
Yeah, yo, Ice Cube, you know, choosing not getting vaccinated over 9 million, my guy.
It was for a movie, but they were
forcing him to
so
get
so now he should go back March 1st. Yo, you guys still want to do that movie?
Yeah. Yeah, yo.
Fuck, like, that'd be funny, like, if, like, he comes out on March 1st and he goes on Twitter or, like, Instagram. Yo, guys, you still want to do that movie?
Yeah.
That'd be freaking hilarious.
And I should be like, yo, Ice Cream. I mean, Ice Cube.
Yeah, Ice Cream.
Yeah, Ice Cube.
A new rapper, Ice Cream.
Ice Cube. So you want to do that song? Fuck the vaccine coming straight from the government. Yo, they ain't shit.
So that's going to be on Podmatic.
I guess so.
COVID diss?
COVID, yeah.
COVID diss.
Yeah, man. But yeah, yo, shout out to all the protesters still. And yo, I heard that, what's it called? Something about, yo, with the protesters, they're trying to, like, freeze their bank account or some shit. Yeah, like, but that.
I don't know. It's either that. And then I heard that's happening.
Yeah.
And I also
which
was
is
reading
also
on
fucked.
Something else.
Yes.
How the government just wants to freeze the banks. Like, yeah. All the banks, not even just the protesters.
Yeah.
Just freeze them.
Yeah. All because we're all because not everyone is not complying with your bullshit vaccine program. Fuck out of here, bro.
And then there was one guy, I don't know if you've seen the video.
Yeah.
You're like, yo, my bank account's in the negative. You could take whatever I have.
Exactly, bro.
And the guy's like, yo, you can take whatever. I'm in the negative. I don't care. Like, he was just living his life down there. He's like, yeah, I think he was drinking something.
Yeah, man.
I'm in the negative, man.
Yeah, exactly, you can take whatever. Bro. Yo, it's bad enough we live on this fucking floating rock of a planet, and we have, where we have to pay to live on this planet, bro.
Bro, especially gas right now.
Yeah, so who cares about the free banks?
Gas.
Yeah, I know, it's ridiculous.
For half a
right
tank,
now.
Bro, I'm paying what I used to pay for a full tank.
Exactly.
Because I'm pretty sure in yours, it's a full tank is what, probably close to 100 or more?
Yeah.
In
which
your SUV?
I'd rather just pay 65 and done.
65 what?
Yeah, for gas each week.
So that's your...
That's like three quarters.
Three quarters?
Full. Yeah.
For a half tank of mine is like 50.
Yeah.
I'm like, bro, this gas prices was never $50.
Exactly, man.
$50 okay for a full tank.
Yeah.
But not half.
It's like, bro... Like,
bro, it's regular gas.
Exactly.
It's regular gas I'm putting into my car.
Like, dog, if I'm going to spend $100, I'd rather spend that on fucking groceries than fucking gas, bro.
Because freaking right now, I might as well just freaking lease a fucking Tesla. I'm serious, bro.
Oh, yeah, trust me. I feel you on that one. Yeah. Where bats can no longer need gas, just charge your car, bro.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Fuck, I'm down. Like, I'm down to get a Tesla, bro.
Lease? You sure about leasing, or would you finance it?
Not really lease. I don't know. I was just saying, like, I'd rather
Yeah, have a I know. Tesla. You're just putting it out there. But it's like, yo.
But, if... fuck, I'm down to finance one. I don't care right now. It's yeah. getting to the point I do not...
Yeah.
want to keep spending like money like that on gas.
Exactly, bro. Yeah.
Like, I don't know if it's going to get higher and then drop again. Like, I don't think when it gets to like $2, like when it gets to like 170, 180.
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to drop like that much ever again.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised, bro.
Like, who knows? Because I think in the summer it could be reaching like 180, 190, they're saying.
Yeah.
So fucking $30 not going to even give you
exactly.
nothing.
Yeah, this part of the pandemic strategy.
Exactly. You know? Whoever's not vaccinated, tax everybody else.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, they only
I don't want to be surprised whoever does their taxes this year. Most of everybody is going to have to owe back, even if you didn't take
Yeah, with that vaccine tax bullshit.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, you didn't take money? Yeah, we're going to tax you anyways.
Yeah, I heard they were doing that in Quebec.
Oh, yeah, you're
Remove
Canadian?
That shit.
Oh, yeah, you're Canadian? We're going to yeah. take your money.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you're an essential worker? Yeah, we're going to take your money. Fucking stupid people.
Honestly,
man.
Bro. Yeah, yeah, I'm glad that shit's getting lifted. I can at least go to the gym, too. I haven't been to the gym in 3 years because of this.
Bro, you could have used the PDF.
I know I could have, but, like, I was loafed in. But, like, I wanted...
Because I heard if you went to the gym, all you had to do was just show them once.
Yeah.
And it was already in the system.
Yeah, back before it was only QR code allowed.
No, before QR code.
Yeah.
So the before, because remember how with the PDF file?
Yeah.
With yours and mine.
Yeah.
You could have went there, showed them. And
yeah.
And you're in the system already.
Yes,
so
yeah.
So you don't, even with the QR code, you're already shown as you're vaccinated, so you're good. You don't have to keep showing anything.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're already in the system.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I remember, like, what's it called? Like, 2 years ago, I could have went, but you have to, like, book an appointment to be in,
Yo,
at
I'm
the
just,
gym with
yeah.
a heavy cask with like...
It's either that or you sat in the big lineup for, like, waiting
yeah,
for
yo.
People that don't show up.
Yeah, it's like, yo, I'd rather go when things cool down and there's no restrictions.
Yeah, so basically March 2nd.
Yeah.
March 1st is going to be probably packed.
Yeah.
Or, like, the whole month of March probably going to be really packed.
Yeah, I'll just go, like, the weekend of. I won't go the very first
yeah,
day.
Yeah, or just... So, if they're going to open that up, do you think the gyms will open back up, like, 24-7? Or do you think they'll still... Because I don't think any gym right now is 24-7.
Yeah. Well, the capacity limits are starting to get lifted now. But I'm pretty sure, yeah, it will be open 24-7.
There's still limits on that?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, for the gyms?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Capacity limits and have to show proof of vaccination. Which is dumb. It's like
no, you don't have to show like after March 1st. You don't.
Yeah.
Have to
oh
show
no, talking like for now.
Oh, for now.
Yeah, yeah. Leading up
oh,
to
okay,
that
okay.
day. Yeah.
I
like,
was gonna say. So what? When you go in the gym, they're gonna be like, "Are you vaccinated? You're gonna have to go on this."
Yeah, yeah.
If you're
this
unvaxxed,
time,
no, you can only
yeah,
do this. You can only use this treadmill, and that's the only treadmill you use.
Yeah, I just put my membership on freeze.
Oh yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
Either that or just turn your basement into a gym. That's
yeah.
it.
We actually, yeah, me and my brothers actually did buy some equipment.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you know, like some pull-up bars and like, you know, a bench press. I don't
Where
really,
are you buying your stuff from, though?
Oh, it was Cody who bought them.
Like off Kijiji or like brand new?
Oh, no, not Kijiji. I forgot which website it was. I think
oh,
off
okay.
Amazon or some shit.
Oh, okay. But like decent ones, no?
Decent ones, definitely.
Yeah,
no.
yeah.
Yeah, yo. Like, I didn't care to buy equipment. You know, I just helped buy the pull-up bar. That's it.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I'm like, yo, at some point, these mandates got to go so I can actually
Wait,
go
but how
the
much
gym.
Is, like, how much is the pull-up bar, though?
Like, $200 for that one.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but the other equipment was expensive. I'm like, yo, I'm not trying to fork out money for that. Fuck that shit.
And then but, he's like, nah, you can't use it, fam. You can't use it.
I mean, I don't mind not using the bench press. I don't bench anyways. I just use dumbbells for benching.
Yeah.
Not the bar. I don't
no,
like
yeah, you
can
still
way.
Use the dumbbells. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. I have my own way of exercising, which I can't wait to do again. You know
what? Jogging, walking.
I don't even like. I'm not even. Well, mostly on the what's it called? The treadmill.
Oh, the treadmill.
Yeah, I don't like running and jogging like that.
Really?
Yeah. Nah, I'm not really a runner.
Wow.
Yeah, but I'll still get some cardio in, like do some speed walking on the. Treadmill.
Oh, okay, okay. Or unless we play basketball, there's your cardio.
Yeah, yo, definitely is my cardio there.
Fuck, I haven't played basketball in like so long.
Yeah, I haven't played since the summertime.
And then you're gonna make excuses. No, sorry, I can't play. I'm injured. My coach said I can't play.
Yeah.
I'm unloaded. I'm on a 5-game suspension. I can't play.
Yeah. Actually, no. I'm on a 1-week no-fap streak. Now I'm playing.
I'm joking. Yeah, because I broke it yesterday. No fap streak over. TMI, I know. Okay. Anyways, yeah, what's it called? Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's just get to the funny bars of the week before we wrap up. Mm-hmm. This goes to... Oh, hold on. I even put the thing in my notes, but I got it in my photo gallery.
You got it in the photo gallery. Yeah,
this is by King Chip on the Games Church track off the Jesus Peace album. Seen her with a group of friends. Damn, she got the best butt. Then she turned around looking like Morris Chestnut. hell nah. Goddamn, what the fuck? Even though shit a nigga still might fuck, you can be my plan C just in case my A and B can't cut. Saying, yo... Jeez.
Yo, if we played the bars on the pod, would it be copy like thing?
I'm pretty sure it would. Yeah, I'm not taking no chances.
No. I know.
Yeah.
But I just thought like maybe if you put your phone like that, like so they can actually hear the bars.
Yeah.
But like it's whatever.
So. Yeah, and yo, I almost forgot. We passed inspection last week.
For what? Spotify?
Oh no, for podcast feds.
What do you mean we passed inspection?
Because like yo, I just knew they were. Because like yo, like one day last week. They like our play skyrocketed one day.
Yeah.
Yeah, to as much episode like we had the same amount of plays that day as much episodes. So I'm like, that gotta be the podcast feds going through our shit.
Really? What episode was that?
All of them.
All of them just went that high?
Yeah. Like you know, like each day it shows like the total amount of plays in a day.
Outward on Simplecast?
Yeah, Simplecast, where it shows the analytics.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah, that's definitely podcast feds. Trying to catch us and shit. It's like
there's some Twitter page that said like one guy would like make you like a free website if you give me the RS feed or
spammer.
Something. Spammer. No, like he'll actually there's like a website that actually makes it for you.
Oh, it does.
Yeah. So like later on, because I don't even know where the RS like feed is.
Yeah, I could give it to you.
Yeah, just give it and then I'll type it in like that website and
it can just put it in there.
Okay. Yeah. So like the RS feed will just make you like a whole website type thing.
Yeah. You know.
Because I also wanted to do that too. So like everything's on there. Twitch, YouTube, all on one page type thing.
Yes.
So
yeah.
Like everything's there.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then on YouTube, you know how like you have like the long ass title for like each episode?
Yeah.
I try to put that on YouTube. Bro, there's like.
Not enough character limit.
I'm like, yo, what the fuck?
Yeah, the character limits, yeah.
Or if anything, if later, like, you know when you put it on thing tomorrow?
Yeah.
If you can shorten it up. Or like whenever, like if you can just
or
do
just
like
give
a
you
short
a shorter title.
Give me the, because I think it'll be better if, like on YouTube instead of just putting out of control episode like 137.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure if we put like something like in the headline, maybe.
Yeah, that's
maybe
short
like
enough.
More people will like click on it.
Yeah.
Because I know like we're getting more than like 50 views now because I keep posting it on like the YouTube.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
I keep posting it on like. The Facebook group chats, not chats, but like the pages for like
yeah
podcasts.
The pages yeah
yeah yeah
okay
like on there so that's where like and then now if you type in on if you go on Google and no not on Google if you just open up your internet browser and just type in www.youtube.com/out of control podcast
yeah
our YouTube page will come up
okay
because now we're like I think 100 and something subscribers
nice.
And they said we can change. We can change the URL. Before, it was like all these numbers and all this other bullshit.
Yeah.
So now you could just type in the whole thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice,
so it's like way better now.
Okay.
And don't forget, Donda 2 on here.
Yeah.
Okay? Donda 2.
Yeah. Buy your $200 Steam speakers. Not playing. STEM.
I don't even know what brand this is.
Yeah. Like you see the plus... On top of the minus, looking like a
cross.
Yeah,
I can just add like white out right here.
Yeah, like it's a Christian speaker.
It's called Ultimate Ears.
Ultimate Ears, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It's pretty good still.
Yeah, but yeah, we done. Episode 137 is a wrap. All-Star Weekend continues. I'm staying home again this weekend.
Man, staying home.
Yeah. I was half an hour late for work today because
really?
Of the snow. Yeah. I had to take my time. Yeah.
I'm surprised you even went today then.
Yeah. I mean, it was okay. The roads were still clean. It's just I had to brush snow off my car and shovel the driveway a bit to get out.
But as long as you told them you were late.
Yeah. I called it saying like, yo, I'm going to be half an hour late. My bad.
And they said, okay.
Yeah. They know how far I drive from work. So they're
okay
with it.
Then They're like, yeah, but you got to make it up next week. No, I'm playing.
Oh, no, they ain't say it. Cause it's
no,
like,
I'm joking.
Yeah, because like, yo, how the hell am I supposed to get to work on time?
No, yeah, exactly.
After the amount of snowfall the night before.
Yep.
So, yeah. But anyways, yeah, yo, I'm tired.
Man said he's tired. It's only 11:16 a.m. Yeah.
11:06 Oh, yeah, what's it called? It's just Friday, man.
It's just Friday, man.
That Friday night stretch of trying to do the pod after working hard this week.
Yeah.
That's and I got to work again Monday, holiday, family day.
Oh, I'm back Monday, too.
Yeah. Oh, you're back.
But I'm glad I'm... Yeah, because, like, I'm Sunday to Thursday, right?
Yeah.
So then... So our Sundays are Monday. So yeah. So they said they're giving... Like, so when stat comes, they give us off Sunday stat.
Yes.
And Monday's regular pay. I'm like, you guys are fucking assholes, man. Like, you guys are assholes.
Yeah. I mean, I'll take it. At least it's stat pay.
No, it is.
Yeah.
But, like,
I mean,
stat.
I mean, no, nice. Not stat. I mean, time and a half
yeah,
pay.
Yeah, you get time and a half.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
I'm saying for us, we don't get time and a half.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. For working the day before a holiday.
No, the day of. Like, the we're working of. On the actual family day Monday.
Worst buy.
And we're not getting...
Yeah, that's why I don't fuck with Best Buy. I call it Worst Buy.
Yo, that's a funny bar of the week. That's a funny bar of the week, fam.
What's it called? Okay, yeah, we done. Episode 137 is finished, y'all.
DJ 91 on the ones and twos.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And we are done.
We finished, y'all. Team LeBron for the win. Let's go.
Let's go.
Yes, sir.
My cousin's on that team. Luka?
Who winning the MVP? Luka Doncic, probably?
Who's winning the MVP?
Yeah, of this All-Star game. Who you got?
Who do I got?
I forgot who won it last year. Oh, yeah, Giannis won it last year.
I think a new person might win.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure, yeah. And the year before, Kawhi did.
Yeah, he did.
Who won 2019? I forgot.
2019? Don't remember.
I remember still.
I don't know. It could be. It can go... Like a lot of ways for someone to win.
Yes, yeah.
So I don't even know. Because I know like LeBron and Steph probably just not going to even do much. Maybe just shoot for... Like Steph will try shooting from half court again.
Yeah.
100%.
Oh, yeah. Or behind the half court line.
Yeah, or behind. Or even from full court.
Yeah.
From his own foul shot.
Yeah, I remember. That's what Damian Lillard did last year All-Star
game. They were going back and forth.
Yeah, Mad pulled up from behind the half court line and drained a three,
but
bro.
But All-Star weekend's going to be... Like, obviously different because he's not in it this year, right? So
And it's in Cleveland. I don't think we've ever seen a Cleveland All-Star weekend in our lifetime.
No, that's like not ever. That's like basically what happened with us, too.
Yeah,
like
in Toronto. Yeah, first time ever, bro.
Yeah, they need to bring it back.
Definitely, bro. Yeah. That's what makes 2016 great, bro. One of the greatest years of the past decade. All-Star weekend in Toronto. It gets no better than that, bro.
Yo, that would have been sick if had All-Star weekend in 2019, the year that we won.
Yeah.
That would have been fucking sick.
Oh, that would have been crazy, bro.
But it was weird because remember when we went to that NBA thing, the NBA corner?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the NBA. Because
that was like
winner's
right before,
corner.
Yeah, because that was right before playoffs.
Yeah, that was the same year we won.
The same year we won. So I'm thinking, was this planned?
Yeah.
Like,
and James Worthy was there. Yeah.
Yeah, because like. Yo, the trophy was already down here.
Yeah, yo.
The trophy never comes down here at all.
Never. We've never seen an NBA trophy until that point.
I'm like, yo, like, did Drake put out some money for us to win? I don't care. Yeah. We still won. I don't care. Like, the NBA corner thing, that was pretty sick.
It was, it was. The trophy was in this nice, cool mirror.
Yeah, and it was free.
Reflective room. Yeah, it was free. And we took the picture, and I put in the caption, like, hopefully, you know, the city will get this trophy. And lo and behold, it happens.
Exactly.
We manifested it. It went into existence.
And then when I won the 3-point thing,
yeah,
like that was pretty sick too.
Yeah, and what's it called? You guys went the next day with your brother, and you guys actually took a picture with James Worthy.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, met him, and he was trying to persuade he was talking to the Toronto fan base.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Leonard's good, but you know next year he's signing with the Lakers, right? I'm like, no.
Wait, talk about Kawhi this year.
No.
Oh, back then.
When he was still with us. No, no.
In free agency. Yeah.
In free agency.
Yeah.
He said if he doesn't stay with the Raptors.
He's going to leave for the Lakers.
He's going to come for the Lakers.
I'm because he wants to go to L.A.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm like, no, he ain't coming.
I didn't even see that coming. I was thinking, like, yo, if he's going to leave us, it's likely going to be for the other team. Because I remember he wanted to be a Laker.
Yeah. Yeah.
But when LeBron came there, he changed his mind. He really was like,
Because I don't think he, like, But for him, he doesn't want to like team up with like another big star type yeah, name,
yo.
Right?
Like, yo, they had LeBron and AD. They had the cap space to sign Kawhi.
Yo, I think he got injured again, AD.
Oh, yeah, he did get injured again.
And he just played, well, this is what, like not even his fifth game, I think. Not like, even his fifth
from
game.
From the last injury.
From his last injury. Because he came back, you said.
Yeah.
He put up some nice numbers.
Yeah.
I don't know how much, but he's still like, he played decent and he's injured again.
Yeah, and this is third injury already this year. It's like, god damn.
Third one already this season.
Yeah, yo.
No way, bro.
Yeah, man. And he's poor LeBron. LeBron.
Just call it a season for AD.
Man's 50 years old carrying the team on his back. That's likely well just, not going to make the playoffs.
You might as well just call your son now, bro.
Yeah. but I'm pretty sure, like, yo, this is like on front office and on LeBron. And like, you know, not just LeBron, like
not even that,
whose idea was it to trade for Westbrook? This wasn't working. Y'all were better off without him, with Caruso, Montrezl Harrell, KCP on your team.
Exactly. But they've really fucked up because Lowry or DeRozan was supposed to end up there.
Yeah, yo. Now look at DeRozan now. Look at Miami. Look at Lowry now.
DeRozan's the only person now with that 7-game streak.
Oh, yeah. He broke the record. Will Chamberlain's record for most consecutive.
Because first he tied the Chicago record with Michael Jordan.
Yeah.
And then he beat it.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, fuck.
And he built Will Chamberlain's record for like most consecutive 35-plus point games, 50% shooting.
Yeah, because he was tied with 6.
Yes.
And then.
It's 7.
Yeah, so now it's 7. Yeah. With DeMar, yeah.
Yeah, yo.
Yo, I can't wait to see him tomorrow in the All-Star game.
Yeah, and what was I thinking? Thinking that he was overpaid. Nah, he's definitely worth that 3 years, $85
million. No, for sure he is.
Every penny.
For sure he is. But like, obviously, he to me now, I don't know if he would play like this if he was on the Lakers.
Yeah, I don't think so now.
Because now it just seems like he's like he has something to prove.
Yeah, like
because he wasn't, but like he was still balling like this on the Spurs.
Yeah,
but he wasn't going off.
Like not this. Like this.
That's what I'm saying.
It's like, bro,
it's either that or the East is too easy for him.
Yeah, I know. It's like crazy. Like ever since he came back to the East.
Yeah, because when he was in the West, he was still balling out, but he wasn't having like games like this.
At
like,
yeah, exactly.
Like all the time.
Yeah, yo, but this
it's either time, that or it is off season. He just went crazy and just freaking worked out, freaking did lots of shit.
So. Yeah, I guess he really had a chip on his shoulder, like, you know, leaving the Spurs and going to Chicago.
Oh, yeah, but he fits nice on the Bulls.
He does fit nice on the Bulls, for real.
So we're going to be seeing them in the playoffs. They haven't been in the playoffs for a while.
Oh, Raptors?
No, Bulls.
Oh, Bulls. Okay. Yeah, because, yeah.
Yes, like, the Raptors never been in the playoffs for a while, Cade.
Yeah. Oh, no, I thought you meant, like, first-round matchup.
No.
Yeah. Like, depending on how the seedings go. Yo,
that would suck.
Yeah, if we face Chicago in the first round.
DeMar kills us.
Yeah.
Like, DeMar, you know, like, the same stat that you retweeted on Twitter, how LeBron James killed Kyle Lowry and DeRozan?
Yeah.
Now it will be DeRozan killing Pascal and Fred VanVleet. Now, that would be funny.
If that were to happen.
Yeah. Because I'm pretty sure, like, just say we do face him, Chicago's winning that 100%.
Yeah, 100%. You
100%.
Know? Like, dog,
unless we buy out some fucking superstar that I don't know of.
Yeah.
Because, like, in buyout season.
Yeah.
Which I still think we should have maybe, like, got someone else.
Yeah.
It's all good.
Yeah. But, heck, like, what's it called? Like,
but the other guy's been playing nice, too, anyway.
Thaddeus Young, he's been playing good. He's still nice.
Because I've seen some comments on, like, even the Raptors Nation.
Yeah.
They're saying, like, he already plays like he's been in Toronto for, like, a long time.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so basically.
That veteran experience, 15 years.
Yeah, basically that, or just when you come to Toronto, you're here to play. You're not here to fuck around.
Exactly, thing, right? Bro, you know?
It's
so,
the only team in Canada.
Yeah.
You have to prove that we can ball.
And Masai Ujiri's the boss.
No, I'm the boss.
You ain't no boss. Oh, we need Melo. Fuck out of here. When Kawhi left, we need a 35-year-old Melo. Nah, fuck out of here.
So isn't what's his name that you just signed? That we just traded? Isn't he in his? Is he like 34 or 35?
No, but you said Melo was going to be our Kawhi replacement. That's what I was saying. I'm not talking about the age.
Oh, the age.
Because you said when Kawhi left, we needed Melo.
Even Melo's doing better than Westbrook on the Lakers.
Yeah, but...
And Melo's coming off the bench.
Yeah, but we're talking about Raptors now.
Okay, but I'm just saying, don't diss my boy Melo.
I know.
And I still can't find his jersey for some reason on the Lakers website. I'm going to have to customize it myself.
That's a problem. How come Melo don't have his jersey for sale?
Yeah, because when you go on the Lakers like website, he's not there.
That'll make no sense at all.
And when I type in Melo, it goes to the fucking Nuggets jersey. The fuck do I need? Yeah, the Nuggets jersey, but that's going to cost even more than the Lakers jersey.
Of course.
Because that's his retro, like, Mitchell and S fucking jersey.
Yeah.
I'm like, I also, speaking of Mitchell and S, I heard Jay-Z bought it.
Oh, yeah, him and, I him forgot and I who. Think
someone else teamed up and bought it, right?
Yeah, for like a lot of money. 300 mil.
Yeah.
Yeah, yo.
That's crazy, though.
Of course, yo.
So I don't know if there's going to be changes coming or they're just keeping it the same.
Yeah.
Because I'm hoping he brings the prices down because that shit mad expensive.
It's mad expensive, eh?
Yeah. Because even the All-Star jersey I got from Kobe.
Yeah.
I forgot what year it was. The red one with the star on it.
Yeah.
I think the year when he was facing Jordan in
The All-Star game.
Yeah, in the All-Star game.
Yeah.
Like, that one was fucking crazy expensive.
Oh yeah, that's definitely... Especially since he's dead now.
No, but even before that, even when he was alive, it was still expensive.
Oh, yeah, because it's some rare shit.
It's like, yeah, because usually, like, the jerseys on there, they're, like, stitched and everything, too.
Authentic ones, yeah,
basically, like, yeah, like that.
Okay.
So, yes.
Yeah, yo. And, like, yo, the fact that, you know, we're even talking about the Raptors, you know, being in the playoffs, they're overachieving, bro. So... You know, everybody wrote this team off.
Are they still in six, though?
I believe they're still in six. Yeah. They won their last game against Minnesota.
Okay, so.
Yeah.
Yo, but I'm surprised. Like, the Denver game, that was close.
So there
some really weird calls in that game.
Yeah, the game we lost, yeah.
And then the other game on, what was it, the Monday? We fucking lost
To the
bad.
Pelicans. I'm like, chase this shit.
So bad.
Yeah. But at least we made up for it after the last win.
They were saying, like, we look so tired. I'm like, but I don't understand. Like, you almost beat Denver.
Yeah.
But lose, like, what? I think we lost by, like, 20?
20-something to New Orleans.
By 20-something to the Pelicans.
Yeah.
And then you lose by one to Denver.
Yeah.
How the fuck does that work? That's, like, yeah. Like, I can understand, yeah, we play better against better teams. But the Pelicans, bro, you should at least win against the Pelicans.
Yeah, that's the thing about the regular season. You're always going to have games where you beat good teams.
No, but yeah, but that doesn't make any sense. So,
where you barely lose to a good team, but lose to a shitty team.
That doesn't make any sense
at all. Or you lose to a shitty team and beat a very good team.
It doesn't make any sense.
Like when we lose to Detroit, but beat Milwaukee. It
doesn't make any sense, bro.
Yeah.
All right, bro.
Yep. Episode 137 is a wrap, y'all. DJ 9-1
Podcast Poppy on the ones and twos. We are out.
Let me give me some rest. I'm tired, bro.
And we are done, son.
Yep. Enjoy All-Star Weekend and stay. Yeah, I'm not going to say stay. Well, whatever.
Team LeBron.
Just stay indoors. Stay warm. It's cold out here.
I'm hoping Luka wins MVP.
Yeah.
That's where I'm going to go.
Your boy, Luka Doncic.
My cousin, Luka.
Peace out, y'all.
Peace out. Now we're going to put the ending screen on.
Yo, what up? This is DJ 9-1 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace. We out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 9-1 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace, we out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media.
at peace. We out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace. We out. Until next episode, take care. God bless. Yo, what up? This is DJ 91 of the Out of Control Podcast. Thank you so much for tuning in to this new episode. We hope you enjoyed the show. New episodes dropping every weekend. You can follow me and The Real Matt Lore on Instagram and Twitter. Our socials are in the episode description provided. And you can also listen to us on Apple, Podbean, Spotify, Google Play, and any other platforms that you may listen to podcasts on. Screw SoundCloud. We're done with them. And also, for those who are listening locally, if you're looking for a DJ for any of your events coming up, feel free to hit me in my email or on my social media. And peace. We out. Until next episode, take care. God bless.